We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting, dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we're looking at Power Pack, Grow Up, Issue 1. This is a one-shot from Marvel Comics in 2019, written by Louise Simonson. June Brigman did the pencils on Growing Pains, which is the primary story. Roy Richardson was the inks. Tamara Bonvillain, colorist. Guihiru, artist on The Gift, which is the backup story. BC's Joe Caramagna was the letterer. And cover art was by June Brigman, Roy Richardson, and Rachelle Rosenbaum. Sarah Brunstad was the editor. Will Moss, supervising editor. Tom Brevoort, executive editor. Now, the cover's okay. It's just kind of generic. There's lots of blank space. It could have been a little more action-packed. And the paper quality on the cover is very, very thin. The paper quality is really low. Low end on the whole issue, but the cover is the worst. I think the cover is actually a little bit worse than the interior paper. Probably not, but it feels that way. So it's really low end on that front. Well, the main story is about Alex is having his 13th birthday, and they are going to a concert of Lila Cheney's in the park. And of course, Lila is a friend of the X-Men, so they expect to see some of the X-Men there, and they run into Kitty Pryde. Well, meanwhile, out in space, there's a horse-headed alien named Kofi, who's flying a ship called Friday. And Friday is actually Power Pack's spaceship that they loaned to Kofi back in like the 80s. And Kofi runs into some brood trying to capture a baby space whale. And his interference causes the brood to chase him. The ship gets damaged in the pursuit and they have to make a pit stop on Earth. Thankfully, Power Pack is there to help out. They've never fought the brood before, but Kitty Pryde and Wolverine have, and they're at the concert. So they lend a hand. And it's actually a pretty well-written story. It's definitely aimed at younger readers. There's good morality tale in here. There's some good setup. It's a good family story. You know, one older brother doesn't really want to help out, but he sees that they're in danger, and he recognizes that he's got a responsibility to try and help them. And then there's this little backup story. Same writing team, just different art. The art is horrific. It is just terrible. It's bad manga art. Everything looks really blocky. The kids look weird. I hated that art. Where the art in the main story is actually pretty good. It's very reminiscent of like the lower end 80s books, and the story is simplistic. It's not that hard to follow. All in all, I'd say this is a great kids book, but it's priced at $5. If it had been slightly shorter, drop the backup story and make it like $2.99 for younger kids, then it would be a really good recommendation. As it is, this is Power Pack, so it's gonna end up in the discount bin. Louise Simonson did a great job writing it. I thought it was handled maturely and written at a good target age of like 8 to 12. Nothing too complicated, good morality tale, but the cover price restricts kids of that age from getting it. For the most part, there's better things they could be spending that much money on, like mobile games and video games and whatever else. So I think it priced itself out of its target audience. If this had been written as like a loss leader, which is a retail term for an item you put on sale to bring people in and then they'll buy other stuff while they're in the store, you might lose some money on this one, but you gain it back by other purchases or future purchases. I think that would have worked for this. This should have been priced at $2 or even $3. Drop the backup story, and it would have been a much better sales technique to gain the audience that you want to get with this. I think on that front, the pricing failed, but the story is really good. If you're a Power Pack fan from back in the 80s, you'll really like this. It's a good nostalgia trip. It's really well written. It's got a very cohesive story. It's simplistic, but it's aimed at 8 to 12 year olds. So if you got a kid in your life, grab this out of the discount bin, because buying it on the newsstand for $5 probably isn't worth it. Your kid-friendly books have to be a lower price, something that kids can actually pick up on impulse and read. Unfortunately, that's just how it works. But it is a well put together book, except for the garbage art on the backup story. Thankfully, that's pretty short. But that's just my take. As always, thank you so much for listening and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you want to help the channel in other ways, links are in the description and on the about page. And as always, we hope to see you on the next one.